Toy House 60.
Alright, I've just had about enough of this for one night.
Next!
Woo!
Oh boy.
Billy, I'm so excited, it's your parent-teacher conference!
Woo!
Come on, Mom and Dad! Hurry!
Hold on, son.
Coming, dear.
Woo!
Made it!
Woo, let's take a seat! Sorry, teacher, we sure had a long day today.
Welcome.
Thank you, teacher. Pleasure to be here.
Woo!
Alright, let's get going.
Where are y'all from?
From the great Lone Star State of...
Texas!
Yep,
that's right.
I'm sorry, I'm Matilda.
Or you can call her...
Pineapple Tilly.
And I'm Pineapple Riley.
Is that a chicken?
Yes, ma'am.
Organic, free-range, farm-raised chicken.
Yep, raised right on our ranch.
We call him Pineapple Chili.
You get it, Dr. Quinn?
Okay. Anyways, I'm trying to wrap this night up. Let's begin. Billy and Millie, please step outside.
Yes, ma'am.
Will do.
Woo!
Come on, Billy, let's go.
Well, let me start off by saying Billy is a very happy kid. Probably the most happy kid in my class.
Aw, honey, you hear that?
Mm-hmm, that's our Billy.
Mm-hmm.
Very friendly and very confident.
Uh-huh,
like a true cowboy.
Well, I'm very happy that he has a very good home life from what I'm seeing.
Aw, did you hear that, honey? I think she complimented us.
Mm-hmm. Well, Billy, I will say he is a very hard worker. He might not always get things like right away, but he does work really hard and he does try a lot. I'll definitely give him that.
We instill a great work ethic in our kids at a young age. Isn't that right, Tilly?
Yep.
Uh-huh. Every morning since they were young, they feed the ponies at 5 a.m. They have to make sure all the ponies have enough water and hay.
Well, that's awesome. I'm glad you're making your kids do chores at an early age.
Yep. Are those cowboy boots?
Oh, yes. Special handcrafted leather boots by Master Artisan in Kansas.
Mm-hmm.
We were on the wait list for over a year to try to get these boots.
That's very nice.
And our kids are not just doing chores. Our kids are gonna take over the ranch someday.
Yep.
Our family ranch. We have long, proud family history.
Uh-huh.
Well, that's nice.
We plan to have this ranch for many generations.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I'm glad that you're making long-term plans with your kids.
And after they move the hay, they have to put the feed out
for the chicken.
Mm-hmm. Chicken sure gets hungry.
Wow, that's some back-breaking work.
Hard work makes character.
Yep.
Bop, 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 bop.
Are you gonna eat that chicken?
Oh, no.
Good golly. This one I'm keeping as a pet.
I do commend his work ethic and hard work. However, he doesn't seem to do as well on my tests. So, unfortunately, he's still at a B. But there's always a chance to raise his grades up.
Well, make sure he studies harder.
Uh-huh.
Thank you for your time, teacher.
Yep.
Let's go.
Interesting.
Next. Come on. Let's hurry.
Come on, Mom. It's our turn.
I'm sorry. I had to change Misha's diaper.
Welcome.
Martha. Martha Mello. I'm sorry I had to bring my baby. Couldn't get a sitter in time.
That's quite alright. Thank you.
Well, the good news is that Marcia is doing well, especially for someone that just joined our class.
Oh, that's wonderful. I was worried that she wouldn't make new friends right away.
Well, I wouldn't worry about that. She seems to be doing just fine. And I was quite impressed by her science project using marshmallows to make an erupting volcano.
Oh, she sure is clever.
Well, thank you for the update, teacher.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, here you go. Keep up the good work.
Alright, thank you, teacher. Have a good night.
Mm-hmm. I'll try.
Come on, Mom. It's finally our turn.
Alright.
Bye, Mom.
Good luck.
You look kind of familiar.
Oh, you probably seen me in a few daytime soap operas.
That's probably true.
I almost got the Emmy last year.
Oh, that's cool.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, and I've also played a high school teacher before.
Probably way more fun to play one than to be one.
Probably heard of the show, General Education.
Sounds familiar.
It sounds like Papette wants to follow your footsteps.
I'm sorry, your name?
It's Paulette.
Oh, Paulette.
Yes, she does want to be an actress.
She's trying to audition for all these little kids' roles.
And she's working in a movie theater on the side.
That's very good. I'm glad that she has a lot of ambition.
She wants to be a movie star.
Ever since she starred in that commercial when she was a little baby,
well, that is quite a challenge, but I really commend you for helping her achieve her dreams.
Well, she currently has a B+ right now, but that could be because she's overwhelmed with working a part-time job and everything. So she definitely could use some extra time on her schoolwork.
Here you go.
Alright, thank you, teacher.
I'll make sure she gets this.
Wait, Peppermint. Hi, Peter. How did your PTA go?
I don't know. I think my dad seems okay with it.
Oh, cool. We're gonna go get ice cream. Oh, wait. Before you go, meet my dad. Hey, Dad.
Peter, we gotta go. We're gonna miss night practice.
But wait, Dad. Meet my friend, Peppermint.
That's nice, Peter. Come on, we gotta go. I'm double parked.
Peppermint, like, knows how to, like, skateboard, and she knows how to, like, snowboard.
Yeah, that's nice. Come on, Peter. Let's go.
But Dad, she knows how to, like, play soccer, too. She could totally be, like, in one of the leagues. And, like, we could, like, totally, like, teach her how to, like...
Peter, we don't have time for this. Come on, let's go.
Dad, hold on.
Oh, what is going on over there? What are they doing over there? Excuse me.
Uh-oh.
Hey, excuse me.
Yes?
What is your problem?
What are you talking about?
Don't be rude to my daughter.
What are you talking about? I wasn't being rude to your daughter.
Your son here is introducing you to my daughter because she's his best friend in school.
Yes, that's nice, but Peter and I have to go. We're late for something more important.
More important?
Mm-hmm.
Sir, my daughter is a very good friend of your son. And from what I saw, your son was very excited to introduce you to my daughter.
I'm sorry, but my son has more important things to tend to right now. We don't have time for these silly things.
Silly things? You mean having friends is a silly thing?
Look, ma'am, I'm sorry if I offended you, but that's not what I was trying to say.
Hey, next!
Hello, Dr. Quinn. This is my mom, Pamela. Nice to meet you.
Ah, Pamcake. What a nice kid. Always there to help others. And she's also very smart. She has never caused any problems in my class before.
Mm-hmm, that's wonderful.
And works excellent in groups and is always there to help others.
That's great to hear.
All right, I give her an A for now, so just keep up the good work.
Thank you, teacher.
I'm just saying that we don't have time for this right now.
You don't have time? We're at a PTA night.
Part of this is to meet who your kids are hanging out with.
Yes, yes, I've already met the teacher, and that's more than enough. Sorry to offend you, but we have a schedule to keep.
I am offended. Don't you think it's important for you to know who your son is hanging out with at school?
I'm sure he's making his own decisions just fine.
Yes, but don't you think it's important for you to be involved in his life?
I am involved in his life.
Well, I meant, like, don't you think it's important for you to be involved in a kid's school social life and know what's, like, going on in his actual life?
I'm sorry, are you a psychologist?
No, but I think it's important for you to be involved in your son's life at this stage to help him develop his identity and self-esteem.
Well, I'm sorry, you're not an expert. You shouldn't be telling me what to do.
I'm not an expert, but I certainly am a parent.
Yes, I'll take your opinion as that. An opinion.
You know, you are really arrogant.
I'm sorry, ma'am, but I also don't think you should be so blunt as to tell people what you think about them.
Sorry. My dad does this with, like, other parents all the time. Oi.
Who is that?
What a rude dad.
I know, poor Patty.
Look, I think I know what I'm doing. I have quite a few medals to prove it.
Well, at least I don't let my quote-unquote legacy go to my head.
How dare you?
You are rude.
I don't think I've ever met anyone that talked back to me like this.
Well, you deserve to know what I think.
I'm sorry. If you don't have anything else to say, we're going to take off.
Fine.
Peter, let's go.
Sorry, Peppermint. I'll see you later. It's okay, Peter. I'll see you later.
Alright, last one. Who's next?
Oh, that would be my cousin.
So, teacher. This is my dad, Sam Cake.
So nice to finally meet you, teacher. I'm Sam.
Bye, Dad.
All right, this night gets more and more interesting. So, are you aware that the science fair is coming up soon?
I'm sorry. To be honest, I'm just so busy. I don't think I heard Tom talking about that yet.
It's all right. I understand. Lots of parents are busy.
Well, first of all, we move around a lot. I'm in the military, Navy SEAL to be exact. So it takes a while for us to adjust to a new place each time.
Uh-huh, I can see that. It's hard to adjust whenever you move.
And I also spend my free time volunteering at orphanages, playing with the little kids. And I walk the dogs at the animal shelter every evening.
I see, you're very busy.
And sometimes on the weekend, as a volunteer firefighter, I get called over to help if there's an emergency.
Okay.
But last week, Coast Guards called me in to help. There was a baby dolphin stuck in a fishnet off the coast. I had to set him free. Poor little guy.
Is there anything wrong with you?
I would hope not. Well, I guess I am just a little bit busy. I mean, it's all for good causes. Except, sometimes I also model on the side. I don't know. These agencies, they keep calling me.
Okay, well, I think this science project is a good opportunity for you to bond with your son. It's a long-term assignment. You can do research in the library or online. This is a semester-long project.
Hope that won't conflict with our plans for spring break. We're going to an elephant sanctuary to rehabilitate the elephants and bring them back to their natural habitats.
Okay, good for you. Well, Tom is a good kid, and he turns in his assignments on time, and I'll give it a B+ for now. Hopefully, the science project will help bring his grade up. Anyways, here you go.
Thank you, teacher. Now, excuse me if I must leave in haste. I have to go cook at the homeless shelter.
All right, that is it. Woohoo!
Toy House 60, Toy House 60, it's Toy House 60. Comment, like, and share, and subscribe before you go.